Hello everyone, today in this video we are going to talk about the neutral point of a bar magnet in Earth's magnetic field. And after this video you should be able to derive and apply the formula for neutral point. This is the picture of Earth's magnetic field, and we know magnetic south and the geographical north of the Earth do not coincide with each other, so there is the angle of 11 degree between them. And towards the geographical north we have magnetic south, and towards the geographical south we have magnetic north. So the reason behind a magnetic compass showing the north is the existence of magnetic south towards the north pole of the earth. So this is the portion of the earth, and we have magnetic field of the earth out here, and the direction is like this. So it can be resolved into two components. One is vertical component and one is horizontal component. So horizontal component is parallel to the surface of the earth. If you consider a place on the earth, then the magnetic field lines will go from south pole to north pole, because we have magnetic north at the south pole of the earth. So these lines are horizontal component of earth's magnetic field. If you keep a bar magnet at that place, then the magnetic field lines coming out of the north can go to the south of the earth, and similarly the magnetic field lines coming out of the magnetic north of the earth may end in south pole of the magnet. And we know when we go away from the bar magnet, the magnetic field decreases. Out here we have a strong magnetic field, so when you go away the magnetic field decreases. Now if we consider the magnetic field of the earth also, now at this point, that is the axial line of the magnet, then we'll see the direction of earth's magnetic field and magnetic field of the bar magnet is in same direction, so the magnetic field gets added up. But out here you can see the magnetic field lines are opposite to each other. So as we know, when we go far away the magnetic field of the bar magnet decreases, so at some point we'll have the magnetic field of the bar magnet and horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field are equal, so that time they cancel each other and we'll have a point called neutral point where there is no magnetic field. Similarly this side also we have a neutral point. So neutral point is the point where the magnetic field of a bar magnet cancels the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field, and we have no magnetic field at that point. So this is the picture where you can see the magnetic field of the earth is starting from south and reaching the north. Some of the magnetic field lines of this bar magnet may go to the magnetic south of the earth, or it may come to south of the magnet itself, and the magnetic field lines coming from the magnetic north of the earth may end at south pole of the magnet. So we have the neutral point on equatorial line. So this is the definition of neutral point. We can use the concept of neutral point to calculate the magnetic dipole moment of a bar magnet. So now we'll derive the position of neutral point for a bar magnet, and north of that magnet is facing the north. And out here you can see at axial line, magnetic field lines of earth and magnetic field lines of the magnet is in same direction, so they cannot cancel each other. But in equatorial line out here, the magnetic field lines of bar magnet and magnetic field lines of earth are in opposite direction, so at some point we have zero magnetic field because they are equal in opposite. Suppose r is the distance of neutral point from the center of the magnet, 2l is the length of the magnet, and m is the magnetic dipole moment of the magnet. Strength of the magnetic field due to this bar magnet at equatorial line is given by this formula. BE is equal to mu naught by 4 pi m by r cube. We have already derived this formula in our previous videos. So at neutral point, the magnetic field of this magnet and the horizontal component of the earth magnetic fields are equal. So I can write horizontal component is equal to BE. BE means magnetic field of the bar magnet at equatorial point. So if you put the value of BE, then you will get this. So now you can find this M. M means magnetic dipole moment, and it can be written as M is equal to 2 into length into magnetic charge, 2LQM. Using this formula, we can find the magnetic dipole moment of the bar magnet. So now in second case, we'll consider a bar magnet and south of that magnet is facing the north. In previous case, north was facing the north. Now south is facing the north. So out here you can see. So the magnetic field coming out of this north cannot end at the south. So it has to come back to the south. And the magnetic field of this bar magnet decreases when you go away from the magnet. And out here you can see at this point, that is equatorial line, the direction of magnetic field lines of the magnet and the horizontal components of earth magnetic field are in same direction, so they cannot cancel each other. But out here you can see the magnetic field lines due to bar magnet is going in downward direction and the earth's magnetic field is going in upward direction. So at some point, the magnetic field due to the bar magnet and the horizontal component of earth's magnetic field become equal and they cancel each other and will get neutral point. And this happens in this side also, because magnetic field lines are going upward and magnetic field of the bar magnet is coming in downward direction. So we get the neutral point at axial line when south pole is facing the north pole. So this is the picture. As you can see, magnetic field lines of the earth is going like this in upward direction, and magnetic field of the magnet is starting from magnet and ending at the magnet. It is not going to the magnetic north and magnetic south of the earth. So now let's derive the position of this neutral point. So as you can see, in equatorial line, magnetic field lines of earth and the magnet are in same direction, so they cannot cancel each other. But out here you can see the magnetic field of bar magnet is coming in downward direction and magnetic field of the earth is going in upward direction, so we'll get the neutral point in axial line. So same thing, R is the distance of the neutral point, 2L is the length of the magnet, and M is the dipole moment. So my magnetic dipole moment can also be written as M is equal to 2LQM, where QM is the magnetic charge. So the strength of the magnetic field of a bar magnet in the axial line is given by this formula. So just a difference, in previous case we did not have 2, but in axial line we have 2, because we have stronger magnetic field in axial line than equatorial line. So at neutral point, the horizontal component of earth's magnetic field and the magnetic field due to bar magnet at axial point is equal, so I can write BH is equal to BA. Now if you put the value of BA, now we'll get the position of the earth's magnetic field. So by knowing BH, that is horizontal component, and the distance of the neutral point of the bar magnet, we can easily find the magnetic dipole moment of the bar magnet. Now we'll solve some question on earth's magnetic field. So the first question is, the declination at a place is 15 degree west to the north. In which direction should a ship go to reach the east? Meaning of declination is the deviation from the real north point. So that means when you keep a compass, instead of showing the real north, it will show the magnetic south. And in some of the book they may say this point to be magnetic north also, so don't get confused. So the compass is showing 15 degree away from the north. To reach the north, you have to cover 15 degree, and we have to go to the east, that means 90 more degree from here. So that means 15 plus 90, that is 105. So to reach out here, so we have to go 105 degree this side. So similarly, you can try this question. So out here, declination is 20 degree towards the west. So the ship has to reach northeast. So you can try this question. Horizontal and vertical component of Earth's magnetic field is 0.22 Tesla and 0.38 Tesla. Find the resultant intensity of Earth's magnetic field and angle of dip. So horizontal component and vertical component is given. So you have to find the total magnetic field of Earth at that place. So using this formula, you can find the total magnetic field. So in order to find the angle of dip, you can use this formula. So the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field at a place is 0.4 into 10 to the power minus 4 Tesla. And angle of dip is 45 degree. So we have to find the value of vertical component and the strength of total magnetic field. So out here, horizontal component is given. Now you can find the vertical component using this formula. And to get the total magnetic field. Next question. The magnetic moment of a bar magnet is 1.6 ampere meter square. And it is placed in the magnetic meridian with north pole. With north pole pointing south. So the neutral point is at 20 centimeter from the center of the magnet. So we have to calculate the horizontal component of Earth magnetic field. And if the magnet is reversed, that means north pole pointing north pole, we have to find the position of the neutral point. So first, neutral point is given, so we have to find the horizontal component. So to get the horizontal component, we use this formula, and this formula is for north pole pointing the south. So using this, you can find the horizontal component because magnetic dipole moment of bar magnet is given. Next, you have to find the distance of the neutral point when the magnet is reverse, that means north pole pointing north pole. So for north pole pointing north pole, this is the formula. And we have got BH from the previous case. So you put the value and you have to find the distance, that is R. I think this is the end of the video. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.